Mario nerf by just backdooring constantly with him and trying to make plays. The funniest thing ever was, so MIA was in the LCS, obviously, so whenever I'd see him, I was like, hello, friend, and he thought I was calling him Fred for the longest time, for some reason, and then, so basically, he thought I didn't know his name or something, and then, eventually, someone told me, like, you're calling him Fred, right? I was like, what the heck? And then I went to ask him. I was like, no, I'm saying friend. And it was pretty funny. But anyway. So I guess I'm laying against Quinn. This matchup is pretty brutal for Cap because it's very hard to get damage off on Quinn. And they're just like, oh, what the heck? Oh, wait, what the heck? Oh, it's Zyra top? Okay. I thought they were doing like a dual, like AP lane bot with like Nami, Zyra, but I guess that's not right at all. So I guess I'm laying against Zyra, and I went cloth 5, which kind of sucks. I don't have a ward right now either, but Zyra's actually really easy to gank. If Maokai lands any form of CC, if like Maokai gets a W off on her, then we'll pretty much guarantee a kill. I'm probably gonna take Shumpa at level 2 just in case I get ganked. Or if Maokai makes it to top, then he can get some nice follow up. Yeah, I don't think she would've ward. Oh, he's talking about mid. No, actually, Zyra probably warded this. Now that I actually look at it. He's sitting very far back in the rush. He's very squishy though. He only has 400 HP right now, which is really low. You gotta watch out not to get eaten into our range. That would be awkward. We can totally dive her. If I tank turret aggro, or if he tanks turret aggro, either way would be fine. What the hell? This plant's like killing me so hard. I just flashed. I didn't want to risk taking more than one turret shot there. If he stayed a little bit earlier, or a little bit closer in turret range, then I would have had to flash after I picked up the kill, but I didn't want to risk anything there. So my flash and ignite are down. I don't know where the jungler is, but I have a Maokai sapling and try. I'm going to risk pushing up another wave. Just so I can deny Zyra as much EXP and CS as possible. They have Lee Sin jungle. Ooh, that would have been very risky if I stayed any longer. It's a good thing I'm back here. Let's see. So Zyra top. What is their team? Quinn, Lux, Lee Sin. Honestly, I feel like I'm just gonna do really well in this matchup from here on out. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just take a Seeker's Arm Guard. Generally, you don't want to upgrade Seeker's Arm Guard early against a magic damage matchup until, yeah, if you can afford to. But I think with that first blood gold and the fact that I'm going to get an early Seekers and be able to charge up a lot of stacks on it, I'll be able to run over Zyra here. Although she's not that bad, to be honest. She has two ways of disabling my ult, and she has long range harass, but she barely got enough levels in earlier up until now to be able to show her strength in lane. When Zyra came out, Zyra top was actually something that I messed around with a bit, but I decided to bench it because, I don't know, it just seemed a little risky. It's not bad by any means though. And the fact that she can place plants for like pseudo wards for herself is pretty damn cool. I'm gonna get some earlier points into Q here actually. I got 2 points in W, 2 points in Q. Generally against melee matchups top, I'll always max W first, but Zyra's is a bit of a different story. And the move speed that I get from W isn't really going to help me that much against Zyra, so I think getting some earlier points in Q just to be able to harass her back will definitely prove lucrative. One cool thing about this matchup is that I can negate a lot of her damage if I use my Shunpo intelligently. And I can't obviously dodge like everything, but like for example her Q and her W and her E, I can easily just like Shunpo onto her and dodge any potential DPS she might gain from that. I just hit level 6, she's still level 5. That means I'm going to have a bit of an advantage here in terms of being able to jump on her and pop ult. I'm gonna pop my ult and some health pots here. If she chooses to stay in lane, then I think I'll be able to dive her. Pop another health pot here. My ignite's not up for a bit. She's really scared, and she realized that Zed was roaming top, so she's actually gonna back out. If Zed's gonna pick up the kill on her, then he's gonna get it. She doesn't have flash. Yeah, she's definitely dead. I'm gonna push up another wave, and then move to try to help Zed. I think he's okay though. I'll guard him against the nefarious Lee Sin. Lee Sin's actually bot lane, so we got nothing to worry about here. I'm just gonna push this up. He missed his Qs, but he still picked up the kill. Good work, friend. Alright, actually Zyra's gonna be coming up to get some CS in her turret now. I'm just gonna zone her from it. I have Ignite up now, she's still level 5. Got a lot of harass off there. When Shunpo comes back up I can probably dive her, although she did just hit level 6. It's a little bit scary now that I think about it. Got her. I thought she'd die a little bit faster there. She got the level up after I died, but I didn't quite have enough damage to just instantly blow her up. And I think that was because I hesitated a bit too long. I let her like regen with her health pot for like 4 seconds longer than I actually could have. I could have just went for the dive straight up, but because I was a little bit apprehensive, it ended up taking a bit too long, and that definitely cost me the potential to jump out after I picked up the kill. Alright. I'm just gonna get source shoes here. Zyra is definitely not gonna be getting much more in Mar than that Chalice, and the rest of their team is pretty squishy. I think Lee Sin might upgrade to a Bulwark, but for the most part, Lux, Quinn, and Nami are not gonna get any additional MR. So any magic pen that I'm gonna be able to pick up is gonna be very, very efficient for me. And I'll probably even go for a Haunting Guise as my next upgrade, but it depends how the rest of the laning phase goes. Gonna key max and Q here. Drop a ward. I'm actually gonna ward deep into try because we have a ward mid that's deep on the raid, so I'm pretty safe from most things that'll probably come at me. I can pretty much just poke her at turret here. She just threw out her Q, that's what she's maxing first, so that's a pretty big portion of her burst. Those plants actually hurt a lot though, what the heck. I can't take free damage from plants like that. I actually have to respect them. This ain't no typical support, Zyra. going to be on cooldown for a bit here. I'm not sure where mid went. Maybe looking to make a play on me top? I can't really be sure. Probably doesn't have any idea I'm here, but she probably has like a little bit of suspicion. Ready for trouble. Try proxy next wave, keep her in lane. Magnite's on 15 seconds, so I could definitely look for a dive when that comes up. Oh my god, it barely hit me. I should have hugged the left side a little bit there. I flashed Jumpode to try to get out before she could cast her passive on me, but I was a little bit too slow there. And I had to flash because I was snared by the vengeful plant or whatever. Oh no, that's not what it is. I don't know what it's called. Actually, to be honest though, now that I think about it, I could have Jumpode out, taken like one extra turret shot instead of flashing. And then just made sure to save flash to dodge her passive. That would have been the smartest move. I'm not sure why I went for Shumpo first there. I'm not sure why I flashed first there. I guess I thought I was going to live no matter what. If I could get both off, but I really didn't gain that much distance with my Shumpo flash. I flashed basically like next to the creeps and then Shumpo to gain a little bit of distance. But I could have just Shumpoed to the creeps and flashed out. That's what I definitely should have done. And I'm returning to top with my haunting guys. I don't have enough gold. I didn't have enough gold for ward if I wanted to pick up haunting guys, but it was a big enough upgrade that I decided to forego the ward, and that's gonna put me in a bit of a scary spot. But I still think I'm stronger than Zyra. At least in an all-in, she just used her Kia. Oh, I'm probably dead. Yeah, I'm dead. Oh my, what the heck, he flashed ulti? That was a little excessive. He's dead. Let's see if we can clean up Zyra. Oh, that was an accident. Ooh, good flash. He almost got hit by the Lux snare. That was a nice gank on Lee Sin's part. To see that gank coming, I would have to have a ward in their river brush, or in their lane brush, and I probably wouldn't have bought one for that reason anyway. It was a good roam by Zed, picked up the retribution kill on Lee Sin. He had a 2-kill shutdown and I was 3-2, so not too much gold on my belt under my belt. I didn't have any summons up there. Lee Sin used flash, Zyra used her full combo, and Lux and Zed roam top. So I think that was a pretty even trade for us. I might want to say we came out a little bit ahead, but for the most part, oh. Zed's showing his juke skills. It was a bit dangerous for me to jump on her like that, and I think she kind of baited that pretty well, because normally she'd never walk up that close into Shumpo range, but I saw an opening to make an aggressive play, and I took it, and that's what ended up happening. Gonna push this up another way. She's got him pretty strong. Like, her spells are doing a decent amount of damage, and all she has is the haunting guys. I can understand why people play support Zyra so often after laning against Zyra, who's been admittedly pretty behind for most of this lane. I feel like she's baiting another gank. She's probably gonna plant this. If she's baiting right now, I'd be very surprised. use my ult. Dropped her quite low. Don't have kill potential though. Have to back up. My ignite's back up too. Yeah, just enough damage to finish her off there. She was trying to bait. She thought she could take me out with her ult, but she was really, really low. So I think that was a bit of a questionable play, at least in my mind. I'm going to try to push up one more wave. Lee Sin's mid, Lux is mid. Their whole team, no one in their team is in a position to roam top right now. I'd be the most worried about a Quinn roam, but Quinn I can see very well in her minimap. She's all the way bot lane. So I'm just going to push up one more wave and back here. Alright, let's see. So I have 1400 gold. I can pretty much buy anything under the sun, except for like 60% of the items in the shop, but let's see. What are they building? Just go for Rylai's. Oldie but a goodie. I think Rylai's is extremely powerful on Katarina. Regardless of team comps, regardless of what people are building, I think it's just an amazing item that you can't go wrong with. It gives her so much crowd control. She has three AoE abilities that she can apply. One which she can apply from range and can keep a whole team at bay. And since Haunting Guide is already a core item, then Liandry's is not a very crazy upgrade path. So if you get Rylai's plus Liandry's on Kat, then you just become like ridiculously powerful. Oh shit, he's going in. Run for Quinn, but Quinn got away too. That was pretty scary. Use my flash on that as well. Only fools hesitate. What's Quinn's health at? Oh, she has a BT. She might even be full health. That's kind of risky. Shut down. Nah, never mind. She went bot. Pushes up another wave. And go back. Well, we did get dragon, but at what cost? Ooh, nice juke. Could have sold my ward for a blasting on right now, but I'd rather have the ward in my inventory and just wait till I get 1400 for Rylai's, and that's because the ward gives me more play potential than 40 AP probably will. At least for the next few minutes until I can farm that up. There is going back top. I think they red respawn. What the heck? And
MIA.
Oh, Lux is scouting us. It's kind of risky. We need backup. Holy shit, he got the red. And... oh my god. E plus Shumpo. I need EQW there to kill him. I wouldn't have enough damage. MIA just dipped out on me. I got abandoned. Nah, it's all good. I should have started running. I could have Shumpo'd my way out, but I tried to fight the Quinn, and that ended up being a mistake. Lee Sin's most definitely dead. Nice job. Alright, I got my Rallies finished out. I'm gonna run top. Actually gonna get Homeguard boots. Let's see if Zara wants to push up another wave. If she does, I'll punish her severely for it. Damn it, she backed. She was pretty low on mana, so I can understand her wanting to back, but I don't think she would have expected anyone to get top in time to stop her from killing this last creep wave. That's why I picked up the Homeguard boots right then and there. Not gonna be a big waste of gold though. They're just really good boots for any scenario. Allow you to reduce downtime when you come out of base or die or whatever, and the endgame potential to be able to defend your base or come back after a death and stop a Baron attempt or whatever is huge. Especially if you have TP. I really like Homeguard TP, but at the same if you have TP, then the other boots are really good too. The upgrade, what's it called? Distortion, there you go. You get 25% reduced cooldown on TP and Flash. So Flash TP Katarina, Ghost TP Olaf, definitely not a bad choice to have those boots either. Moving with Zed. I don't think she sees us. We two shot her. Like we both use our ults, but that was even a bit excessive there. Got him slowed. Help, team! Oh my god. Had nothing up there. If we got there a little bit earlier, we probably could have fought it as a 4v5, but me and Zed just got picked off after using both our ults to take down Lot of Mortis. Oh no! He's dead. Oh, Mega going in. He's got this. He's got this. He's got this. He's got this. There it is. Oh, what's good? Penta. He's giving it to him. Oh my god. Oh my god. I was like so sure that was a Penta kill because he dodged the E too. Holy crap. Scumbag Lot of Mortis. That was funny. Oh my god. That was brutal. I mean, that's just like, that's like etiquette. Solo queue, someone gets a nice quadra kill. Gotta give him the Penta, man. A lot of times though, I don't realize when people are getting like killing sprees. Like I've gotten a pentakill and I didn't realize it. Cause sometimes you're just like not thinking about that stuff. But that fight took a long enough to where it's like pretty obvious. Nah, it's all good though. Lot just did what he had to do. They're like still in this game, so it's like it would be pretty bad to expect him to just throw, or not throw, but like give up a free death like that. He's dead though. But it'd be a bro thing to give up the Penta. Oh, I'm moving on this guy. I shumped on the lantern. I instantly grabbed it. I didn't know that works. Throw the lantern. I want to see what happens. I think I clicked on it and shampoo at the same time. I don't think if you just auto shampoo. I don't think if you shampoo on lantern does it, if it automatically does that. But I could be wrong. Come here. He's pretty slowed. Please. Please. Dear God, naked stop. Oh my God. If I had wards there, I could have just flashed to get the kills. But I didn't really want to risk it. I didn't really want to waste flash on that. I'm pretty low. I can win it back. I got Zhonya's here. Yeah, you can shampoo to the lantern, but like I shampoo, then I instantly like I don't even like I wasn't sure if I clicked on it or not. That's why I was confused. I think I clicked on it when I shampoo like instantly, but because I think if you cast a spell, it's different than grabbing the lantern. But it felt to me like it did both, regardless of what I wanted it to do. That's why I was like kind of confused. Oh shit. Help me! I'm so dead. Quinn's too fast. Oh my God. I just walked into like four people. That was stupid. Get an extra ward. I want to test it again. I probably could have fought that if I just engaged on him immediately. That's what I was going for, but then as soon as Lex showed up, I was like, that's kind of shady. I think I'm just gonna back out. Got the dragon. That's good. I'm probably gonna go for the Leandre's upgrade next. Get that synergy going with my Rylai's. This could be bad. We don't have Ezreal. He's a lot of our farm right now. We had a ping, but they dropped their ward. They scattered us out. No, save me. The reset that didn't come. That's still alive, but I think he's gonna die if he goes into that. Damn, I could have played that fight better. My nose is bothering me. I need to get some water. Could have gotten way better. I initiated, I disengaged Zhonya's, but then I wasted time jumping onto I basically wasted a Shunpo reset jumping onto Nami there. And then I didn't have Shunpo to re-engage. And then I got the reset on Zyra, but we were a little bit split. I couldn't actually clean the fight up like I probably could have been able to. That was pretty bad. That's split pushing. Does anyone on the team have Zhonya's? Not yet. No one can actually stop it from split pushing. You can one shot pretty much anyone on their team. Nice try. He went for the young flash hook. It did not come though. We have to create pressure though for Zed to actually get a good split push off. Yeah, that guy's dead. Free in him slash Baron, depending on what they choose to stop. He got the in him. Now they're trying to stop Baron. They still have their Lee Sin with smite up, so could come down to a smite war. Oh, he stole it. No going back. Well played, sir. But that ended the game. My god, how much AD does Zed have? 400. Oh! Nice job. So it closes out pretty well. Zyra versus Cat.